Hey everybody, welcome back. So yeah, it is morning, day 41, and we're just placing these spikes out. We're just picking up where we left off in the last episode. And we're gonna get two rows of spikes laid down, and we're gonna start upgrading them to full wood, because we don't have any scrap iron. That's the best we can do. Okay, I'm seeing some zombies. We should probably go take care of them before they cause any issues for us. Water's always good. Okay, so that's no big deal. Why am I hearing zombies inside my base? Did they spawn in there? Seriously, you guys better not be freaking spawning in my base. I don't care if you crawled in from somewhere. But that can't happen. Jesus. Well, at least they're tearing the house down for me. Slowly. I swear to God, they better have jumped in from the other side over there. And not spawned in here. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to deal with all of this, like, ASAP. Although we haven't had any issues, really. It's only been a couple here or there. The only issues we've had is that frickin' giant horde that came in. So yeah, let's just, let's time-lapse this. Dinner. 106 degrees I am. I'm gonna have to change some stuff with that. I want to fix it anyway. I just want it to be balanced, you know? Everything should be balanced. I hate it when things aren't balanced properly. Especially the weather survival. But honestly, I don't know how to balance it. Like, the way they've done, the way the insulation works on the clothing. The best way to balance it would honestly be to remove insulation from almost, well, from all armor, for starters, and then just make it so that clothing, like, you have to wear a coat to stay warm, right? You have to wear, like a bandana and shades, sure, can cool you off, because you do need to have some sort of clothing that can give you the effect of cool, right? A cooling effect. But wearing armor should not, like, basically for the balance standpoint of the game, right? Basically what you should look at is clothing, your undergarment, and things like your coats, like a puffer coat. That's what you're wearing to protect you from the elements of the game, right? To compensate for the elements of the game. Not armor. Armor's there to protect you from the damage. You know, it's a completely separate mechanic. It should be separated. And I don't have the time to balance it right at the moment. But I will definitely try. Okay, so let's get our blocks now. Now it's 111 degrees and I'm dying. Literally. And I have shades on. And I have shades on. It's 82 degrees outside. Do we have chrysanthemum? I don't even know if I planted any, to tell you the truth. Doesn't look like it. I should start planting it. Start growing that over goldenrod. At least until I get the survival fixed. The weather survival. I mean, I don't want to turn it off, because that's just cheap and, you know, a lazy way out. To be perfectly honest with you. It's a cheap and lazy way out. And, I mean, it's not no big deal if you guys don't like to play with it on. I completely understand. But it is, for me, it's a cheap and lazy way out, because I can deal with it. And I don't mind dealing with it. So I need as much survival aspect as I can get, really. Even if it's not, you know, proper or balanced. Because I can balance it. That's the difference. Not everybody can balance it. Hell, the fun games can't even balance it. I don't think they understand certain mechanics of the game that they even put in, to tell you the honest truth. Not that it's a bad thing, not that I'm dissing them. It's just, you know, it seems to be the case sometimes. Okay, I want one stack on me. Damn, I need like, oh, so much stuff. So much stuff. Did I collect my scrap iron from here? I did. Oh, okay, so when that's done, actually we'll just go like this. It's only another 58 concrete blocks, so it's such a slow go for the blocks right now. We may as well farm, honestly. We'll grab our scythe. Put away these nail guns. What else can we put away? It'd be nice to have a spot to put our clothing, but okay, when we go fight, we're gonna put that on. I want that on. Actually, I probably won't even be able to do that until I balance it, to tell you the truth. Oh, we're gonna have to eat. What's going on here? No one should even be in here. Damn it. So this is why I have to make sure there's no blocks that zombies can spawn on in here. What am I doing? Food. So we'll eat up. And then we'll take care of the farming. I haven't done a whole lot of time-lapsing yet in this episode, so, you know, there's something wrong with me, obviously, so may as well do some farm time-lapsing. No, but it seems to be the best thing to do, right, when I'm... For a lot of the stuff in this game, it is probably best just to time-lapse it. Like farming, upgrading, anything that's, like, purely repetitive. Which is pretty much 100% of the entire game, though, to tell you the truth. I still haven't dealt with these things yet. I know I can use an axe, pickaxe. I'm lazy. Just lazy like that. See, like, we've done good. Like this, I'm happy with this part of the wall. If only the rest of the wall could look like that. Oh man, that'd be sweet. That would be sweet. Okay, what do you figure, guys? I think we should I think we should go out there and do some farming. I think so. I mean, we're basically wait either that or we go mining. I mean, take your pick. It's six of one, half a dozen of another, right? And the farms are ready, so we may as well do them. Drink our coffee so that we can continue to do this at a fast rate. Damn it, I always do this. When I start farming, I have zero frickin' thirst. Actually, you know what cools us off is the yucca. So we could actually just drink yucca juice. Just making sure we got lots of room. Get all these blueberries. Make some ink now. Compost, whatever the heck we want. Get all the wheat. Wonder if I can make it so it's a little bit better at collecting them all when you run. Like, that's full speed. And as you can see, it's like every five blocks or so, it misses a plant. And that's because of the delay. I wonder if I can adjust that delay down so that that doesn't happen. I mean, there's no reason for it to have a delay that makes you have to go back over your crops again. That's not the whole purpose of it. Okay, now let's head in. What I want to do is I want to repair all the dirt with our grass. And that's another reason why I have grass seed, is because, I mean, if you want to stay in a compound like I'm doing, I am going to have a little grass farm. Oh yeah, I'm going to grow my own grass. Yes, I am. You'll see. I want to be fully self-sustaining in here, and the only thing I have to do is go outside to frickin' repair. So now I don't know. But I mean, you have like 1,000 hits before you have to worry. Right. Or 200, I think it is. Yeah, dirt has 200 hit points. And hitting it with the scythe or the right click of the machete only takes away one HP. Because I can't make it do zero damage. Otherwise, I would do that. I would do that. So every once in a while, you're going to have to go like this. It's either that or don't use the machete. Which is, you know, an option. or don't use the scythe, because you are going to get, you know, damage done to your crops, to your dirt, which is just going to cause you to have to do this every once in a while. But I'd say it's worth it for the bonus stuff that you get. Like, I can't do nothing about it. I can't change it so that it doesn't do damage, right? Just can't. Even punching it, even if I made you punch it, you'll still punch the dirt and it'll still frickin' do one damage to it. But I say the farm that we've got is like a pretty good size farm. It's an average size farm. It's the farm that I am balancing the mod for. So I mean, if you want to farm double this, you know, go right ahead. But honestly, I don't think I could maintain it. I don't think I could stand to maintain a farm any bigger than this. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of maintenance, as you guys can see. You know, I didn't have to do this right now, but I'm showing you, this does have to be done at some point. At some point, you are going to have to get out there and start repairing that dirt. Either that or dig it, like, wait till it destroys and repair it, or replace it, but I would advise against that. Look at all the potatoes we have. So you know what we're going to do is keep one stack, get our 55, and then turn the rest into compost. Right? That's what we should do? No. Screw that. We're gonna wait. We're gonna save it for Omnigel. We are going to save that for Omnigel. Now I think we already have the coffee beans. So it'll be easier if I just go like this. There, so I have the replacement coffee. I want to stack up everything. So like yucca, we don't need yucca. So we already got the seeds for that. For aloe, we only have that much. And for wheat, oops. For wheat there. Goldenrod. Got lots of goldenrod now. So we're gonna have wheat, potatoes, yucca, coffee, aloe. So we got 29 for the aloe. And that'll be good for the aloe for now. And then blueberry seeds. Oops, I always do that. God damn it. Boom. So I think that's it. Actually, before we go anywhere, let's double check on our forges. Make sure we're pumping out cement. That's the whole point. And I'm not farming because I want to farm. I'm farming because I have to wait for cement and concrete mix. We are going to have to go get more stone though. That used up all of our cement, right? I think so. So that's perfect. Okay, so we really have to think about maybe making some more storage chests here. Like, we're at the point now where I absolutely have to. I thought I had some made up. No? No? I guess I lied. No big deal, we got some now. Okay, so let's put one there. And... oh, we don't have the space, and I don't want to put it way up there. I don't like it there. I want to replace this one. So I'm going to have to put stuff away temporarily in here. Sorry, it's just hard for me to see what's all exactly needs to be moved there. I could have relooted that, but can't be bothered. Can't be bothered. So this is gonna be our good stuff. Gonna use that vitamin. Lots of cement. Lots of concrete mix. Let's get our concrete blocks going. Another 77. So yeah, I think, actually, maybe, I'm gonna farm by myself. That's gonna do it for this episode. So you guys don't have to watch me plant all these seeds and fertilize them. Next episode, we are gonna time-lapse downstairs. We're going to need a lot more stone. We have no stone left, and that's our main focus right now. Stone, sand, concrete mix, blocks, finish this wall, get the lip on the wall, steel. So the more stone I can get, the more steel I can get, and hopefully those chicken coops will give us a mushroom seed, because we need to start growing Omnigel. Like, that's basically what most of this is going to be turned into. I'm going to only plant what I need for food for, like, bare minimum crop size for food, and then the rest is going to be pretty much drink and Omnigel, right? Like, what I need for drinks and food, that's going to be bare minimum. Coffee's probably going to have its own full roll no matter what, but as you can see, we're bringing in coffee faster than we can drink it now, so we're good on that. I probably won't time lapse the farming, even though I said I did. I realize that. You guys are probably going to be like, well, where'd the time lapse? Well, maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I don't know. Only time will tell if I decide to do that, because I am cutting this episode here instead of continuing on. And I'm going to plant that by myself. And then I'm going to start digging out by myself as well. But in the morning, we'll start up again, and I don't know where we'll be at. We'll probably be still digging. And if we are, hopefully you guys don't mind, because we are going to time lapse that. We need a bunch of stone, we need a bunch of blocks, like I said, bunch of concrete mix. I want to finish this wall, I want to finish those spikes. So yeah, we got some stuff to do. Yeah, that's going to do it for this episode, guys. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.